जेंगो एप्लीकेशन इज जेंगो प्रोजेक्ट इज एक्चुअली कलेक्शन ऑफ मल्टीपल एप्लीकेशंस. सो इनसाइड अ जेंगो प्रोजेक्ट और अ जेंगो एप्लीकेशन वी कैन क्रिएट मल्टीपल सब मॉड्यूल्स और सब एप्लीकेशंस. सो ईच सब एप्लीकेशन कैन डू इट्स ओन टास्क और कैन इंटरेक्ट विथ अदर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द सेम प्रोजेक्ट और कैन ऑल्सो इंटरेक्ट विद द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ सम अदर प्रोजेक्ट्स ऑफ सेम एनवायरमेंट. सो बेसिकली ए जेंगो बेस्ड एप्लीकेशन इज ए प्रोजेक्ट इज ए कलेक्शन ऑफ मल्टीपल एप्लीकेशन. सो लेट्स सी हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट एन स्टैंड अलोन एप्लीकेशन इन साइड द करेंटली रनिंग जेंगो प्रोजेक्ट. सो आवर जेंगो प्रोजेक्ट इज बेसिकली इज मीन्ट फॉर द बैंकिंग सिस्टम. नाउ बैंकिंग सिस्टम में हैव सेवरल डिफरेंट मॉड्यूल्स. वन इज मॉड्यूल फॉर कैशियर. वन मॉड्यूल फॉर कैशियर टू क्रिएट अकाउंट्स टू एड अमाउंट इन दैट अकाउंट टू डिपॉजिट अमाउंट टू विदड्रॉ अमाउंट टू प्रिंट पासबुक टू प्रिंट हिस्ट्री टू ट्रांसफर मनी फ्रॉम वन अकाउंट टू अनदर अकाउंट. सो दीज मे बी द फंक्शनैलिटी ऑफ कैशियर मॉड्यूल. बट देर मे बी अदर मॉड्यूल्स. वन इज ए टी एम मॉड्यूल. वन इज ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मॉड्यूल. वन इज ऑनलाइन बैंकिंग मॉड्यूल. सो देर विन बी मल्टीपल सिमिलर मल्टीपल एप्लीकेशंस विच मे बी वर्किंग ऑन सेम डेटा बेस बट हैव डिफरेंट सेट ऑफ यूजर्स और मे बी प्रोवाइडिंग डिफरेंट फंक्शनैलिटी. सो फॉर ईच टाइप ऑफ अ सेपरेट फंक्शनैलिटी वी कैन क्रिएट ए एप्लीकेशन इन साइड दिस प्रोजेक्ट. सो दिस बैंकिंग प्रोजेक्ट मे हैव मल्टीपल एप्लीकेशंस इन साइड इट. सो लेट्स सी हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट वन एप्लीकेशन inside this banking project. So let's create that application with the name banking transaction, or let's create application with the name transactions, or we can also say it customer accounts. Anything, we can name it anything. So let's create an application with the name customer accounts. So to create a sub application inside it, let's talk about how we can create a sub application inside this main project. So basically, when we talk about projects and app, so in terms of Django, an app is a web application that does something, okay, that does something special. So it may be a logging system, it may be a record of some polling application. Where is a project is a collection of configuration and apps for the particular website. So we have created a banking project, and this banking project may contain multiple apps. So a project can contain multiple apps, and an app can be in multiple. Okay. So to create a project, to create an application inside your existing project, you have one command, that is python manage.py start app. So start app will create a new app with the name, let's say patient app. So in my application, in my project, I want to create a customer app. Okay. So in the banking project, I want to create customer app. So what I do is, I will close the currently running app. And I will just, I have these folders only, banking project, this. Okay. And I am going to create customer app. In my banking project. So if I write here python manage.py start app customer app, it will create a customer app. Let us check if it is created. So I can see that I have one folder here, customer app. So is it visible to everyone when new folder is created?
Yes, sir.
So now let's go to Visual Studio Code and let's see if we have one folder. So we have one folder here. And if you can see, this folder has similar content to your banking app. You have here views. You have admin, some init py, एंड दिस कंटेंट इज सिमिलर टू योर बैंकिंग ऐप. लिसन केयरफुली. सो इन योर बैंकिंग प्रोजेक्ट यू हैव इनिट पाई सेटिंग्स यूआरएल व्यूज डब्ल्यूएसजीआई दीज फाइल्स. सिमिलरली द कस्टमर ऐप ऑल्सो हैज migrations, init py, admin, apps, models, test, views, everything. So a application is nothing but a small project which can run independently but which is part of your bigger project. So this customer app can be now created separate. It has its own views, models, apps, administration, initialization, everything. URLs also, although there is no URL file, we'll be adding one URL file to create new URL for this app. So this app is a sub app inside our banking project. Let's see how we can create user interface for this app. So for this app, we have to first assign this app that this app is a part of our main banking project. So we have to go to settings.py and add one line at the end of installed app list. Okay, similar to here, like patient app is added in the installed app sections of settings.py of our banking doctors project. Similarly, we'll go to settings.py of our main project, and there we'll find name of list of already installed apps. So some system apps are already there in our application. For one for administration of our application, one for login logout, one for creating content types, one for creating sessions, one for managing statistics file, like this. So we'll add our app also. What is our app that we have just created? Customer app, the name of app. So it's a customer app. So we have added this customer app in the list of installed apps in the settings pie of main banking project folder settings pie. Okay, so this customer app is added. Now next process is we created default user interface, default page of this sub application also. So for that we go to views views.py of this app now. So this app has its own views.py, which is by default empty. And here you can create an index page. So index page is index page. The name of index page can be anything, index or main or hello or anything. So index means the default page, the first page of your application. So I've created index page. Let's write here message equal to, let's put this thing in the message variable, and this is our customer app. So our customer app is a default page. The page in name is index page. Let's render this content of index. So we can have separate views for our customer app. So this is the view file of customer app. Now let us link it. So how we can link it? So we should have a separate urls.py file of customer app. So I am going to create a urls.py file inside this customer app. So let's create an empty file first. urls.py. So this is our urls.py of the customer app. You can see here customer app has a urls.py. In the urls.py, we write this code to create a pattern and to link that index. So what we do is we go to the URLs pie, okay, and here we import the path function, then we import views. Views from where we import views? Views from current folder. So the current folder is customer app. The current folder of our URLs file is, the current folder of this URLs file is customer app, and this customer app folder has views also. So if you have the content in the same folder, then the module name is dot. Dot means the current module or current folder module. So we are importing from current folder, what we are importing views, and from the views what we have import index. Okay, got it? Or we can simply write in place, we can write here from views import index. This way we can also write. So views, where is views? Views in the our current folder. Okay, so let's write it. And views, so we can write directly here index, because index we have import for the index. So now this index page is connected to the default URL. Okay, we have not written here home, we have not written your first. If we return empty, if we create empty pattern, then it means the default URL, the default content. So default content is index, and index is a function, and that function returns this message, hello world, this is customer. So this is done. So we have a separate pattern, list of separate patterns for customer. Similarly, what you can do is you can create one more page for that also. So like one more URL, add customer or new customer. So for that, what you can do is you can go to views and write here default add customer user interface request, and you can have a complete HTML here. Content equal to input type equal to text placeholder equal to customer name. Content equal to content plus VR slash input type equal to submit. Value equal to input type equal to button. Value equal to submit. So you can have an HTML like this, and you can render this content. So you can write a return HTTP response and you can return a content from here. I have to import HTTP response also. So HTTP response is from here. So I have one more URL, add customer. Let us add this in the urls.py. So from views import add customer, and pattern here path add customer. Slash add customer. So add customer is the function. So we have created two URLs for our app. Now this URL should be accessible through this, like add customer okay, these URLs should be accessible like this. So we have to bind the URLs of our app. We have to bind all the URLs of our app with the URLs of our project. So URL of our project are these, and URLs of our app are these. So we have to bind this URL with the same URL pattern. For that purpose, we have to specify one line in that urls.py of our project. So we have to write, we have to go to urls of py dot of main project and add one extra line here to combine all the urls of our sub project. So here we write customer. So customer will be the sub url. So main project http://127.0.0.111 something, and slash customer, and after add customer. So all the URLs of our customer app should start with the customer. So our app is customer app. Dot URLs. So we combined all the included all the URLs of our customer app with the main URL of project slash customer. Okay, so include, I should have import include also. I did import for this include also. So this is the import for include. So this is how I combined the URLs of app in my project. Now let us run this. Let us run this again. Sorry. So there is some problem with the from views import. From dot import views dot views, and I can write here views dot add customer. Okay. Okay, so this is done. Now so our customer app add customer is ready, and our default URL of customer is also ready. This is our default URL, index page of customer, and add customer is also ready. So this is way how you can create a sub application in your project and create URL for that sub application. So everyone got this idea of creating sub applications and their URLs?
Yes, sir.
So similarly, you can also create employee application. You can also create loan application. You can also create inside other applications like mutual fund application. So because banking sector provide different functionalities, different services, so for every service they can create a separate application. Why we create separate application? So that multiple developers can work on individual application. मोर यू डू मॉड्युलैरिटी मोर पीपल कैन वर्क ऑन द प्रोजेक्ट साइमल्टेनियसली. सो बिग प्रोजेक्ट कैन बी डिवाइडेड इंटू स्मॉलर एप्स एंड ऑल स्मॉलर एप्स कैन बी डेवलप्ड बाई मल्टीपल डेवलपर्स वन डेवलपर एट ए टाइम वन डेवलपर पर एप साइमल्टेनियसली. सो ए रैपिड यू कैन डेवलप इट रैपिडली यू कैन प्रोड्यूस रिजल्ट इन लेस टाइम. So let's see how we can add data to this application. How we can add data. So we have created the application. Now we talk about how we can add data to application, the persistent data. So you all are aware with basic things of database management system. Yes. Where you can insert, update, delete, create. So I am talking about the same thing. So Django comes with the default database. That default database is SQLite DBMS. SQLite is again a similar database to MySQL, but it is very lightweight. It is come inbuilt with the Python. So there is no need to install it in the Django. So your application is connected with one by default one database, and let me show where is database. So the database is nothing but a file, and that file is here db.sqlite. I think you all can see this db.sqlite. So this db.sqlite is the database of your application where the all tables of database of your project can be stored. Okay. So how this database is connected? This database is connected through settings, and the settings.py file, you can check that there is a database, and this database is connected through database engine, database library, django.db.backend.sqlite3. If you want MySQL to connect, you just need to write here MySQL. But you need to also write username, password, localhost, port number, the database connection string. So we'll see later on how we will connect our MySQL database here in place of SQLite3. So SQLite3 is a standalone database. It doesn't require actually any username, password to connect. So it's a standalone one system database. It's not a client server. So there is no need of username password to connect with this. It's just a file of data, file of content. Okay. So here in the settings.py, we can check which database is connected. SQLite3 database is connected, and the file name of the database is db.sqlite3. Which is put in the main directory, and which we can see here that this is the database. Similarly, we can connect to our MySQL also, but for that we need to provide more information, username, password, IP address of that server, or in place you can write localhost like this. Later on we'll see in that other sections. For the time being we'll use this default database. So tomorrow we will see how to connect with that database. Now to create some data in the database, first I have to set my time zone. So there is a time zone in that settings.py. So I have to find where is time zone. This is time zone. What is the value of current value of time zone here? Universal time zone, UTC. You have to set this time zone with respect to your time zone where you are working, where your system is. So my system is in Indian time zone. So for Indian time zone, I have to write here Asia Kolkata. If you are developing for some client, and so you have to set your client's time zone. It may be New York also, New York America. So okay. So yeah, aapko at least this you have to set. After you set all your database things, which is by default SQLite here. You can create the tables in a database. So there is no need to go to the database directly like we do in phpMyAdmin, where we create the database and create table and column. You can declare your database table using object-oriented approach. So let me tell you, basically your Django is an object relational data model. It helps you to create database with respect to object oriented declarations. You create a class and it create a table for that class. Getting my point? So there is no need to create a table by yourself. You just create a class, declare variable in the class, and Django create an equivalent table for that class. So that whenever you create a new object of that class, that object can be inserted directly as a row in the table. So class represent table, object represent row in the table. Okay. So after you set the time zone, you have to run this command to set up your database. So that everything is set up properly. So the command is python manage.py migrate. When I do migrate, it creates a list of all the tables that you want to create. All the settings we have made. It updates the settings and all initializations. So you can see here, it is initializing everything. So migrate is to set your schema. Schema means database definition, application, administration, authentication, content type, session, everything that you have set. So your settings file is now considered, and everything that put in a settings file is recorded. After you do this thing, now you create the data that you want to save in the database. So here in the Django, data is known as model. Whatever data you want to save in the database is known as a model. So if you want to save the customer's data, you are creating a customer model. If you want to save the loan data, you are creating a loan model. If you want to save the employee data, you are creating an employee model. So for every type of data, you create a model. And models are created using a class. There is a default model class, which is in the models package. So there is a models module, which contains model class. You inherit that model class to represent your class as a database model. So like patient model you see here, we will be creating customer model. Okay, so we go to models.py of our customer app. So we have customer app. We have a models.py. All the database related activity you do in your models.py, you create design of your database here using the class approach, class based model approach. So for every table you want to create in the database, you create a equivalent class here. So what you do here is, first import models, then from the models import model. In this models file, there are several constants are defined, and this model class a model properties are defined. If you want to store customer data, then you create a class customer, which should inherit models dot model, so that it gets all the properties of a general model, a database model. And after that, you can create a name property, customer name property, so name of customer, then gender, then gender, name, gender, then अकाउंट टाइप, देन बैलेंस, देन अकाउंट नंबर, now you have to decide the data types. So data types should be similar to the data types of database. So we have numeric, where, care, character, date, time, like database in the MySQL. Similar data types are provided in the model. So some of the data types are character field, integer field, like this. So our name is character field. Gender is also character field. Name length can be 100. Gender length can be 10. Account type is again character field, so 10. Balance is integer field. Account number is integer field. So these data types we have attached with this. So this class has these properties with the data types. Now I suggest you to add one more, that is when this data is created. So the one more field you should always add, that is publication date, means when this data is added. Although this is not required at all, but you can add it to keep track of when this row is created, when this data is added. Also, since this is a class, okay, so you are aware with a function underscore underscore str. Are you aware with this function?
Yes, sir.
So this function is used to represent your data in the form of a string. So name I want to print here, then after name gender, at one position gender, and then account number, so three things I want to just return. So dot format, I can pass here name, self dot name, comma self dot gender, comma self dot account number, and also let's say self dot balance. So I am giving one more thing here. Three. So I have created a str function that actually converts the data in a string. Okay. So this is I have added. So this model is ready. Now I want Django to create a database table for this customer model. So what I can do is, I have to just run this python manage.py make migration of my application. So here I run make migration of my application, and my application is customer app. So whenever I write it, it creates a model. You can see here, it creates a model for customer. So is model no changes detected, so it already created model. If I make some changes in that model, let's say I updated the name field and I added it, changed it to size is 50. If I save it again and I again run that command, make migration, customer app, then it tells you alter field name on customer. It also reads properly what you have modified in the customer table or customer model. So it also update the database of that customer table, database for that customer table, and alter the properties. So every time you want to change, you can always change in the model, and you should make do the migration again to restructure your database according to your model. So our table is created. Let's see how we can see that table. So after you do these things, you have to run migrate. Migrate is applicable for all the project. So migrate is at project level. So it applies whatever have been migrated. So whatever changes you have made in the customer app, it is now applied. So all the changes have been applied. Two changes you have created, both changes are applied. So database is ready now. So these two lines of code, whenever you change in something in your app, you run this make migration and your app name, and after you have to migrate the complete project using python manage.py migrate. After you have done everything, you go to the admin panel of your Django application. So your Django application's admin panel can be accessed using /admin. Okay, if your application is running, so if you run your application using this run server, then you can access your admin panel. But admin panel needs username and password. So you have to create admin user password for your application. So by default, let me clear you, by default Django provides administration of your website using admin panel. For that you need to create a username password. So for admin panel of your application, you run this command python manage.py create use super user. So you run this command python manage.py create super user. It is asking for username. So I am giving the username admin, then password. Password is, let's say, admin a capital, admin at, sorry, email address. So admin at the rate example.com. It can be anything. Then it asks for password. So password is capital A admin at the rate 1234. Again, rewrite the password, enter the password again, capital A admin at the rate 1234. So I have created a super user of my application, and from this, using this super user, I can log in admin at the rate 1234. So let me run that project again. Let us log in. So I am able to log in. Let me log out and run it again. If I go to login, admin, capital admin, ABC at the rate 1234. So this is how I can log in.
So now you don't see the customer model here. So to display the customer model here in the administration, so to add the customer data through the administration panel, we have to enable customer model in admin.py of our customer app. So to add the customer, we go to the admin.py of our customer app and we add our model in the admin pipe to be managed by administration, admin panel. So we go to admin pipe. So this is our project's admin pipe, customer apps admin pipe. In this admin pipe, let us add our model. Our model is customer. So we should register customer model to be administered through admin panel. Then we can rerun our project. After we rerun our project, and if you go to the admin panel, you can see that customer's app is enabled here and customer model is available here. Now if I click on customers link, I have zero customers. So I can either add a customer through this add customer button, or I can click on add button from here. Ankur mail account type savings. Balance 3000, account number 101, publish date today, 7 days another, Mohit, gender, male, account type current, balance 55,000. Account number 103, date and time 7 days another, Neha, gender female, account type savings, balance 45,000, account number 109, date and time. So this way we have created three accounts. So these three accounts information is visible. So this Neha female account number, this Mohit male account number and balance, this is visible. This information is visible because we have created str function in our model. So if you go to models.py, we have this str function. Because of this str function, we are able to see the data in this format. We can change that format from here also if you want. So this is how we can create database tables using the model declaration, and we can administer all the database tables models using the admin panel.